Hi guys! So today we're gonna talk about jewelry for the body types. If you're new to my channel, you can probably watch some of the videos of my body type series. I'm gonna leave the links down below. I also have a playlist full of body types videos from the first one to the last one so you understand better. So today I'm only gonna talk about jewelry for the body types. If you don't like something, if you don't like some styles, some shapes, or if you think that doesn't look good on you, just forget about it. Just wear what makes you happy, wear the pieces you love. This video is more for those who does think they have a certain shape of their body and they just want to try and see if that really works. So in my last video we talked about dresses for the body types, and today about jewelry, earrings, necklaces, bracelets, rings. And David Kibbe in his book, he doesn't mean a specific style, he means the shape, the size and the form of this or that item. That creates the look, the lines, not necessarily the style. Ring earrings is very popular, but every body type would look its best in a certain shape, color, thickness, and length, and size. But we're definitely gonna talk about styles too. If you go to my Pinterest, I'm gonna leave a link down below, you will see that board that I created. It is called Body Types Inspiration Photos. So if you go in there, you will find 13 boards for each and every body type. And I continue adding there different random pictures that I found on Pinterest to share with you that vibe that each body type has. Sometimes if you look on those pictures, you start feeling that certain vibe that this body type have. Those women that are on those pictures, not necessarily this particular body type that I'm talking about. Otherwise, it would be too hard for me to find a certain celebrity and find a certain outfit that she's wearing to match that. So I was trying to find pictures that would outline the whole look. I also try not to add any controversial photos, you know, sometimes when it's obvious that the body type, let's say, is soft and small and she's wearing something for tall, dramatic woman, you know? I didn't put in there that. I just try to see the harmony between the body and the clothes she's wearing. Let's start with dramatic. Tall, lean, strong, and narrow-boned ladies with sharp and prominent features. Jewelry is best when it's sleek and elegant, with an emphasis on bold, modern shapes. Thin and sharp pieces are good choices. And also avant-garde works of art. Asymmetrical shapes work good, and better if pieces are large but not overly bulky. They might not look as good in delicate and antique jewelry, it's just too weightless for them, and it will emphasize the angularity of the body. Also heavy, chunky ethnic pieces, just because that body type looks slightly alien, not from this planet a little bit, not like those natural ladies from planet Earth. Also, if they wear something small and symmetrical, you know, their body structure needs a better support. It needs stronger and bolder accents. It has its softer version, soft dramatic. Very feminine, pretty tall, with prominent feature and normally hourglass figure. Jewelry is best when it's large, bold and ornate. Bold geometric shapes with soft edges. Oversized ornate shapes. All sparkly, glittery, shiny surfaces are excellent. Wild costume jewelry, you know, these women look amazing with us over-the-top jewelry. Jewelry, like super jewelry. They don't look as good in sharp geometrics just because it has completely different lines from their body type. It just can look like from a different person. Also, they look not supported enough with too simple symmetrical jewelry. Delicate and antique pieces can look slightly small on them, too small, because these ladies have large bones and they look pretty heavy. And also, they don't look as good in rough and chunky pieces. It doesn't look too neat on them, too accurate. It looks like from a different person. They need more accurate frame. Okay, the next body type is the softest one, romantic. Small, round, hourglass, delicate, slightly wide, and flashy. As far as these ladies are very feminine, so the jewelry is best when it's delicate and lavish, with intricate and ornate touches. Rounded shapes, curves, swirls, and lots of dangles. Sparkly materials are great. Crystal, gems, glass, polished metal, and also are great antique, baroque, or rococo effect. If they wear heavy and chunky pieces, that can look slightly from a different person, you know, because that will create that contrast between their delicate bone structure and super massive jewelry. Also geometric shape, that is not always going along with their rounded features, rounded lines of their body and face. Avant-garde contemporary styles can also look slightly separate from them. Also, if the jewelry is too small and symmetrical, that can look slightly too small for them just because they have slightly wider flash. Next, we go to theatrical romantic. It's a sharper version of romantic because we can't have softer than romantic, it's the softest. So theatrical romantics is basically narrow, small hourglass with sharper bones and sharper facial features. Still very feminine and flashy. So jewelry is best when it's rounded, ornate, sophisticated, swirling. Amazing would be baroque or rococo. Sparkly materials are essential. Gems, crystal, glass, polished metal. Even for daytime, you know, these ladies can rock those things in daytime. Maybe not overdo them, but still a little bit of that kind of jewelry will add a lot of sophistication to them. The most important for that is delicate and lavish at the same time. If you keep that combination, that would be amazing. They might not look as good in geometric pieces, super geometric. These ladies are very rounded. They consist of soft, accurate, delicate outline. Also sharp, severe, and avant-garde pieces can also be like from a different planet on them. So as chunky pieces and rough and ethnic pieces as well. Like when they're super large, super big, super down to earth, you know, that can weight them a little bit down because these ladies, they look pretty light and delicate and very ornate. If theatrical romantic is wearing something small and symmetrical, it just won't add that lavish vibe to them. It will simplify them. Classic is a symmetrical body type, moderate in size, moderate in proportions. Facial features are normally evenly spaced. These ladies look very balanced, so everything over the top doesn't look as good as balanced. So the jewelry for classic is best when it's elegant, smooth, and symmetrical. Small and slightly geometric shapes are good, and also smoothly curved swirls. Be careful not to overdo. So better go elegant instead of extreme. So basically when classic is wearing something over the top, super chunky hanging earrings like for natural women, let's say, ethnic, heavy, they don't look as elegant with that, you know? Also if they wear like a lot of stones, a lot of everything in that, a lot of ornateness, that can also shout louder than their very accurate features of their face. It can just jump too much forward, kind of closing their beautiful face and their moderate proportions. Soft classic is also moderate in everything. They can be slightly smaller, slightly wider and puffier. So jewelry is best when it's clean, elegant, and softly feminine. It doesn't need to be overdone, just a hint of glamour is great. A bit of a sparkle, a bit of intricacy. Shapes are best when it's rounded, ornate, and flowing, while always remaining symmetrical. So symmetry, as you know from my previous videos, is essential for classics, for all the classics. They suddenly have that sophistication and grace in their look as soon as they wear symmetrical clothes, hair, and jewelry. Circles, slight dangles, swirls, ovals are all very good on them. A slightly antique approach to the jewelry is best. If they wear too sharp geometrics, if they wear heavy and chunky pieces, that can just look totally separate from their body type. It just can't handle it because that is too strong, too jumping on you, too bold. That requires bolder features, bolder bone structure. Again, when they have too much jewelry, that can also hide their beauty behind that jewelry. Everything that is too much also doesn't look very effective on them. Overly flashy jewelry also can be like too busy for them. Dramatic classic is also very moderate in everything, just has some sharper features, a bit heavier bone structure. They can have more sharp angles and broader bones. So their jewelry is best when it's sleek, elegant, but slightly chunky. Geometric shapes with sharp edges look amazing on them. Smooth circles that are crisp and oversized. Better if the earrings are on the ear or spray up, but not down or dangling. Necklaces are best when they're crisp and slightly chunky, and when it's around the collarbone area. Again, symmetrical. Symmetry is the key. So everything that is over the top, let's say super ethnic chunky pieces, that would look great on naturals. And also if they wear something small or rounded, too ornate, too small, too delicate, that can be slightly weightless for them. They need a little bit more weight, more statement, more accent. Now let's go to naturals. Naturals are not as symmetrical. They have some musculature that we can notice sometimes. Normally they're moderate in size They have blunt bones, meaning not sharp, not rounded. They can have sometimes smaller hips and wider chest area. So jewelry for these ladies is best when it's kept to the chunky side with soft and rounded edged geometrics. Interesting how David Kibbe is describing that. He says, your jewelry can either be pieces of wearable art, handcrafted and museum quality, made by an artist or taken from another culture, or it can be bright and funky costume pieces. So earthy materials are very elegant and sophisticated on you. Copper, silver, amber, turquoise, hard-finished enamels, and glass are fun, especially when used in bold colors and very vivid accents. Big, bright beads, chunky earrings, irregularly shaped pins. They don't look as good in ornate and sophisticated styles. It just looks like from a different person on them. You can see that contrast immediately. Also antique rococo and barocco. Also dangly and delicate styles. Also severe and sharply angular styles. Like, let's say, long metal sharp pieces. Also, if the jewelry is very small, very symmetrical, it can show that contrast between the bone structure that is slightly heavier and these tiny little pieces in the ears or on the hands. Also symmetrical and classic styles, it also is more for classic, it just won't look as sophisticated on them. Soft naturals are like naturals, but they can be smaller, puffier, more feminine, and slightly more delicate. But the bone structure is still blunt. It's so sophisticated on them when their jewelry is handmade, when it has some texture to it. So the jewelry should be delicate, but highly creative in effect. Unusual materials, particularly crystal, copper or silver, leather, intricately carved leather or stone, faceted glass would look awesome. Wearable art suits you best. Anything from wild and funky pieces to elegant mixtures of opals, diamonds, and platinum. It must be both highly original and slightly intricate at the same time. Very simple antique pieces are also excellent, especially for the dressy evenings. They might not look as good in severe geometrics, again, doesn't go along with their structure and with their softness. Also, stark avant-garde pieces probably is not for them. Small symmetrical pieces can make them look slightly too simple, and also if they wear something heavy and chunky, that also cannot look as good on them just because they are more delicate. And big and chunky pieces require just a bigger and taller body. Then we have flamboyant naturals. Most 90s supermodels are flamboyant naturals. Tall, long vertical line, wider bones, especially here, blunt bones. So bold and heavy pieces look amazing on flamboyant naturals. They look best in chunky, rough pieces. Like David says here, wearable art that looks as if you picked it up at an expensive gallery or on a journey overseas is excellent. Anything that was created by hands, you know, that looks amazing on them. So your version of conservative jewelry would be a thick and chunky metal. Better if it's in a regular shape and soft-edged geometrics. But if you go for a glamorous look, four jewel pieces would look amazing. They won't look as good in delicate and antique pieces because those are too small for their large bone structure, too weightless for them. Also, if the jewelry is super ornate and intricate, sharp-edged, that also just doesn't go along with the bone structure that they have. They need something more chunky. Also not as good with small symmetrical pieces. Again, that looks better on classics, but for these ladies it just won't add that vibe. It won't support that bone structure, and some small pieces can look too small for them. That can also play as a contrast, and the body will look much heavier than that is. Okay, last but not least, gamines. They are small, they have slightly straight, boyish figure, slightly squarish shoulders, normally they're narrow, sharper bones. So for gamines, jewelry is best when it's small and sharp in geometrics, asymmetrical or irregular shapes. Brightly colored enamel, stone or glass are best. Very contemporary avant-garde pieces, also trendy pieces that accentuate their width. If they wear something ornate, antique, baroque, rococo, that just looks separate from them. Too womanly for them, I would say. Also, if they wear heavy and chunky pieces, too big, too much for them. Also, if they wear symmetrical classic pieces, that can be just not a right frame for their body type. Too simplifying. Soft gamine is also petite, very soft. She has some curves, but she has some sharpness at the same time, unlike romantics, let's say. She looks more like a little girl rather than womanly. So for soft gamines, jewelry is one of their most important accessories. Shapes are best when they're rounded and crisp, whether circles, swirls, ovals, clusters, teardrops, it's all their shapes. Irregular and animated pieces are excellent. Brightly colored pieces would look amazing. Big, bright beads. The best when they have their earrings crisp and on the ear or spraying up a little bit, as opposed to dangles. They would look great with unusual pins. You can show your sense of humor in the jewelry. You can use some very interesting pieces. Better if they're lightweight and elegant. Again, they won't look as good in super huge and chunky pieces, you understand why, right? Because they are small. Also, if the styles are super ornate and dangling, like hanging in here, they might look like little girl is borrowing her mom's earrings. That can drag their face down a little bit, especially when they have slight puffiness on their face, on their body. It can pull them down a little bit, so they do look healthier and more fit when they wear like studs, something on the ear or slightly up. And again, simple symmetrical pieces, and you know, like super tiny, delicate and small pieces can make them look slightly chubbier than they are. And also they have some angularity in their bone structure. Last but not least, flamboyant gamine. Gamine with some drama in her. They are slightly stronger looking. They have sharper features, some slight musculature, small rectangular. So jewelry is one of their most important accessories. It adds sophistication and wit to their look. Shapes are best when they're chunky, asymmetrical, and irregular. Loads of sculpted metal is excellent. Also brightly enameled surfaces and colored glass. If you love antique pieces, go for art deco era, 1920s. You can wear something sleek and streamlined from that era. Instead of, let's say, intricate like Victorian, loads of vibrant colors would look amazing on them. Sparkles and polished metal. They would not look as good in ornate and super intricate and delicate pieces because they are angular. They are more funky in their shape. Heavy ethnic pieces also would not look as good on them unless they are very sculpted in shape. Also, small symmetrical pieces won't look as good on them. Same reason as I said before for other gamines. They're not as delicate in bones. Also, dangly and glittery pieces, like those normal, like jewelry, very girly. Okay, so we talked about all 13 body types. Important thing here is not what jewelry you are wearing. In many cases, you can rock a huge variety of things. It's the matter of head-to-toe look. If the majority of your lines of your outfit will be for your particular body type, then some additions here and there won't make a big difference. So we're always talking about head to toe. It's not that you are gamine, you're having romantic hair, natural dress, dramatic shoes and all that stuff, and then you're wearing earrings for your body type and you look different. That doesn't work that way. It's a composition of so many details, of so many things and lines and colors and patterns. Just keep in mind that that's just a little part of what you can add to your look. Alright, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And in my next video, we're gonna talk about shoes for the body types, so stay tuned. Also, don't forget to go to my Pinterest. See you. Bye-bye.